Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Panther Country. We're covering boys high school volleyball action. Long Wilson, John Swick, number 2-5, hanging out for tonight's call, and Jeff Corey along with production. He doesn't say much, but when he does, he gets right to the point. John Swick, we're here tonight covering a Saegertown team that has a lot of people buzzing.
Yeah, runner-up in the state last year, and this year so far out to another strong start. It's just good to be here with you, Colin, volleyball partner.
That's right. You know, it's great to get out and do some games. You got a senior-laden Saegertown squad, top-heavy, going against a little bit of a younger Cochranton upstart.
Yeah, Coach Johnson has it going. He's been at the helm of the Saegertown program for a number of years now and has had success, and success breeds success. You have a good youth program, which he tends to.
Yes.
And kids feed in, and this is a special group he's had a couple years in a row here.
If you tend the garden, it will grow. Enough of the philosophy. We're ready to get down to brass tacks here.
I think that's a reference to my landscaping efforts I need to put forth here. And I'm not attending to tonight.
That's right. Garrett Custard with the first serve for the Cochranton Cardinals. They're going left to right on your TV. Amy sets. Big kill right off the bat. Are you kidding? Get him a Snickers bar.
Wow, Luke Smith over on the right side comes up, big left-hander, and pounds it in the back row with a kill.
He did. He went southpaw. Right now, Brad Amy, jump serve. Cochran looking to set. They do. They go far side. Oh, what a block. The Great Wall of China. Luke Smith right now is going to get his name in the paper if he keeps this up.
Out of the gate strong. Saegertown had two blockers over there, and nothing to it with that spike.
Again, Amy, 5'9", senior. Be calling his name a lot tonight. Good set by Custard. Blocked and out of bounds it goes. Big hit by Chance Hoffman, number 10, the junior.
And Peter Maddox went up for the block that time. Went off his hands and out of bounds. Side out to Cochranton.
Big serve coming up. Wow. What a man. Dig in the back court. There's that southpaw again. Another great dig. I tell you, Garrett Johnson, he's worth every bit of that $10 million contract. And how about Peter Maddox finishing that one up?
Yeah, I think we're going to see the Amy to Maddox connection quite frequently tonight. That's the first time. Maddox has some hops in those legs. Oh. He got up.
Well, that's it. I mean, you're looking at 6'2", 6'1", 6'2", on that front line.
Oh, man, another strong serve.
Well, these guys are firing cannons right now. Wow, nice shot. Smart heads-up play by Zach Wigton. He's got the headband. It's called style.
He goes down the line that time and found some room.
That's right. He went baseline.
Oh,
wow, and a quick dump serve and a good save by Saegertown. Good punch over. That's legal off the foot. It's amazing. Look at this kid.
I don't think I've ever seen the off the foot.
Oh, and a left-handed shot again, and there he is, Luke Smith. He's got to get a prom date and a Facebook friend tonight.
We got to see the foot kick on replay there.
What a heads up play.
You got to dial that up.
Chance Hoffman, I believe, is the one who threw the foot out there for the save.
It's kind of nonchalant, too. He just kind of went with the little kick.
Big block up front. Saegertown holding fast. Good dump over again. Wigton. I tell you, you know, this is the Cochranton team, too. You got to remember, this Cochranton team has history as well.
Sure does. They've had success in that program, too. It's not as if they're slinking here into Saegertown waiting for a beatdown. They're going to give them all they can handle.
Score's 4-3.
And I think that headband that Wignett's wearing is emblematic of that, my friend.
Oh, look at this.
Wow.
And you know what? Luke Smith has said emblematic this.
Man, he likes that right side with that left-handed spike.
Well, if Cochranton doesn't adjust, it moved the defense to him. They're just going to keep picking that corner. Lucky didn't get away with two hits. Into the backcourt it goes. Good punch over. I tell you what, Cochranton, they're no slouch. They're precision hitters. I'm impressed. Quick tip over, and what a block up front. Good save. Oh, Saegertown's just not letting much go. Wow, that was a tough one. Good save up front by Amy. Two hits.
Double hit. Good rally that time. It was a little sloppy. Both teams really weren't able to get in any type of offense.
I tell you, this is a battle almost of wills right now.
A lot of energy in the building.
Yeah, Wigton, good dig. Wow. Nothing to save there.
That's the first time that Luke Dangle.
That's right,
made
first
the
time
play.
We caught his name.
Yeah.
Number 8, Dangle.
I tell you, that's three hitters that Saegertown has that are legit. Both can get up.
Yeah, Dangle's a 6'2 hitter, so. Oh, you're not going to do much there, kid. You were affronted by Luke Triola.
Yeah, Luke Triola.
Peter Maddox.
Peter Maddox, the double trouble that time.
They were just waiting for that Greenlee offering. They put mustard on it. Look at these serves. I tell you, these kids are. Look at that, that's gonna go out of bounds.
Yeah, that's Luke Triola. We just called his name on that block this time. He gets the slop and kills it. As you said, partner, both these programs have had success, and it's due to their youth program. You grow up in both these communities, and you play volleyball early on.
That's right. You're 5 years old, you're born with a volleyball.
It'd be nice if we had both scoreboards working, but we understand that one of your colleagues, Lon Wilson, was instrumental in taking that out of commission. Is there any truth to that?
That's 100% true from what I gather. Serve far side to Maddox. Maddox is denied. Facebook friend request.
Yeah.
Not accepted by number 8, Ross Mackle.
Ross Mackle, first time we called his
the
name.
The sophomore.
Right. Yeah, he got up. Nice block that time. Prevented the cross court spike.
Only down by two. I'm sorry, down by three now. It's Cochran, and they'll have service on that unforced air coming in with service. Ryan Garris, 5'9" junior. Wow, that's a knuckleball. That was Phil Necro. Good stop up front. Maddox finds the opening. He saw it. He took advantage of it.
Boy, the Saegertown bench erupted on that one.
Yeah, they did.
This is an interesting serving angle. Ryan Garris takes it from all the way on the left side of the court. You don't see often the serve coming from that angle.
Look at that stuff up front. Oh, maybe it's a line violation, yep. Saegertown's gonna get called for the infraction. Hopefully the authorities won't be involved, but Garrett Custard now back for the serve. 7 serving 10, down by 3 are the Cardinals in red. Maddox up front, gonna find Amy. That's gonna be off the hands of Custard. And a good job for number 19.
Yeah,
Grant Felon.
He almost took advantage of it. He kind of mishit that spike a little bit, but it worked to his advantage since it went off the side of the block and went out of bounds. Saegertown with the serve.
Look what they have coming up. I mean, even juniors, Triola, Felon. I mean, they're going to be stacked again next year. Good punch over. Saegertown handles that in the backcourt. We've seen this play before. They got to get this over. Oh, they do. Cochran just.
Oh, here we
go. Look at the big hit. And you know what? Cochran is not losing their composure.
No, you know, Cochran's sliding over with the block now a little better than they had earlier in this game.
Over to Maddox. Oh, and he finds the opening.
So, you know, smart with Amy that time, instead of going to the right side, which he had done a couple times in a row to dangle, he goes to the left side to Maddox. And Maddox can't have two blockers everywhere.
That's
Maddox
right.
is able to get the spike.
He finds the open. Pine puts it down.
That's a smart setter.
Look at this. Oh, that's good. They're going to call that out. That was in.
Is that Chance Hoffman over there?
Line judge called that in.
Yeah, the line judge did call in. Was that overruled?
I'm surprised the Cochran coach isn't
squawking.
It's clearly in. I get paid tens of thousands of dollars. That's in.
Oh, man.
Wow. That was a nice cut.
Well, the second time around, Chance Hoffman drilled that one home all the way across court.
That's right. Cochran is here to get some respect now. They got to make up some ground. You don't want to give the Panthers too big of a lead to work with. Well, a little help off the net. What a pancake save. Nope. Too much fluff in the batter. Cochran is going to take it back.
Yep, that was a hell of a save that time by, what's that, number 20, Garrett Johnson.
Yeah, he put the pancake down. He was flipping flapjacks.
Wow.
That was an aggressive serve, but it doesn't count.
Just a bit outside.
That's right. You hate to give those backs because it's rally scoring. You make it, you take it. It's a best of 5. Maddox now with the serve. Jump serve coming. Hard aggressive serve into the backcourt. Where are we going? Wigton now. No, that's out.
A little too aggressive. Tried to go down the line like he did early in the game, but just overcooked it a hair.
Now up by 6 are the Panthers going right to left. Maddox, second serve. That's up in the apparatus. It's coming down. Whitten's got to punch it over. Does Johnson out set to the front. Amy, where's it going? Maddox crushes the net.
That was interesting that time. Amy, instead of going back over his head, he sees Maddox coming right down right down the middle, down the highway there. Mattis couldn't get it though.
Trying to do a little bit too much. Little pooch serve. Cochran is standing fast in the backcourt. Wigton, he's stuffed up, but it's gonna fall off the fingers.
You know, the block was there and it was set up well, but they just didn't have the back line to come in and pick up the leftover there after the block.
That's right. They're gonna call that one out. Johnson now will take over the service. Tell you, defensive specialist in the backcourt, the 5'9" senior, doing a fine job. Where are we going? Cross court, quick punch over. There's Johnson again. Amy now, where's he setting? And that's gonna be off some hands. They're gonna call fingertips? Nope.
No, looks like he just must have missed that one.
That went long. Luke Triola getting some hops up front. Where are Amy going? Oh, look at this.
Wow.
That's filthy. Luke Smith.
That time they had the block set up over there. Yeah. But it's just tough to get that angle of the block since it's coming across court. Your natural reaction is to stand right in front of them with the block. You actually need to stand inside to succeed on that block.
17-12, Saegertown lead. Wigton punches it over. That's out. They're going to call fingers? Yeah. They are. Got to trim those fingernails, kid.
Yep.
Hygiene is the key to success in volleyball. Now Wigton, look at this.
We don't see that very often.
No, I got to see Wigton play basketball. Good, smart, he's a thinking athlete.
Yeah, that's just a defensive error on behalf of the Panthers. Coach Johnson not happy.
Much better athlete than his cousin Andy Baker if he's watching. Now a little help from the net, that works. Over far side, punch to the backcourt, that's out. Couldn't land it, Chance Hoffman. On a good set though by Garrett Custod.
Yeah, it was. It was right in his wheelhouse. Just
couldn't find the pine.
Yeah, couldn't get down on it.
Up by four, 18-14 right now. Saegertown with the lead here in the first.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Man, I tell you, Chance Hoffman, he gets up and he takes a big wide swath when he takes a swing at that, doesn't he?
He does. Here's Greenlee now. I mean, what do? They feed their kids corn on Cochran and grow these kids, 6'3". That's gonna be out. Coming in right now, defensive specialist, Luke Bean.
Yeah, he's only a sophomore, Greenlee.
Yeah, I know, he's got some ways to go. They got some impressive size. They got Custod at 6'1". Coming up the ranks. Oh, what a stop.
Wow, that was a block by Amy.
I'll tell you, Brad Amy, he's 5'9". He's playing the front row.
He's your setter, goes over there, gets up for the block. And I think he liked that himself.
He did, he was jubilant.
He sure was.
Well, this volleyball at this level, John Swick, it's adrenaline.
It's enthusiasm.
And momentum. It's an incredible sport to watch. One of my favorites.
I think more than most sports that we do watch, more in the big three, if you will. There's more than enthusiasm. It's a timeout Cochran here.
There you go. 21-15. We'll be right back. Saegertown with the lead.
And we're back. High school boys volleyball. Saegertown hosting the Cochran Cardinals up 21-15 in the first game. Take it over, kid.
Look at John Swick taking charge right now. Service by the Panthers, Garris. Custod to the back, blocked up. No save opportunity there. Not with Maddox up front and alongside Felon. That's a tough,
that is.
Tough pair to break.
Unless Maddox is 6'2", but he seems like he plays bigger than that, doesn't
Boy,
he?
Boy, I like this knuckleball serve. It's like Phil Niekro and Tim Wakefield all rolled into one. Oh. Quick over, good defense by Mallard. Cochran is staying alive.
That was a good timeout.
Good time to take one.
Coach Custod.
Now Maddox.
Another knuckler.
To Amy. That's going to be a tough save. Oh, Wigton. Punch over to makes it. Oh, this is insane, kid. It's bananas.
Wow.
Oh, what a save on the floor. Maddox was denied. Amy tries to stuff it. He's denied. Johnson up front. Amy back over. Maddox cross court. Insane!
That was the rally of the night right there. Great play on both sides. Both offenses are working well. Both defenses were returning. And Maddox looked like that was in from this angle, but just a little bit outside. It came all the way across court for that spike.
All right, hats off to Luke Bean. Blocked up front again. Maddox keeps his head about him. Again, back over. They're just playing tit for tat right now. Tries to get that over. He got hands on it. They're going to go Cochran's way on this call. Yes, they are. 22-18.
Cochran are making a run. They're not going into that good night lightly.
No, they're not. The Fat Lady will not sing. She's on Weight Watchers right now. Good punch over. Set opportunity coming. Oh, look at this. Right into the chest plate.
I tell you, when in doubt and when they need a play, they went back to the one they've ran multiple times tonight. Luke Smith on the right-hand side, left-handed, and just brings it home.
That's right. Mackle and Hoffman had a tough chore there. 23-18. That's into the net. That's going to be a favor. Tough one by Kenny Custod. Into the game now. He's a sophomore,
he's a sophomore
too.
Six foot one. Yeah, you mentioned at the top of the show, and it's really true. It seems like a little younger Cochran squad than you're used to. These guys are going to be good.
From what I'm seeing in this young squad, you're going to see some competitive teams here in the next 2 or 3 years. Maddox, oh, puts it down. Wigton can't save it. And that's it, 25-18. Saegertown will take the first game. We'll be back. Game number two on the way from Saegertown. Hang in there. All right, back to action here. Game number two, Lon Wilson, John Swick, number one in your program. Number 2-5 in your heart. That's out. Chance Hoffman sees that one fly, give an early lead to Saegertown.
Yeah, I tell you, the kill percentage is not high on Cochran. They need to be a little more precise. I think they got rattled early in the game when a lot of their spikes were blocked, and maybe it alters your trajectory a little bit and your execution.
That would have been net anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, the Cochran hitters, they're finding a tough sledding against the blockers of Saegertown right now, and you get them more confident with their play.
I tell you what, though, they've got the basic foundation, the defense.
I agree.
And let me tell you what, you start with that, the rest will come naturally. Wigton sees that one fly, too.
They're really going to have to try to go away from that block. It's more easily said than done, obviously, but you're going to have multiple hitters run multiple offensive sets to get a couple different options at the net.
Oh, Maddox said option this. Wigton with a save.
And I tell you what,
the fan's going to go home with a souvenir.
I tell you what, how about this start? These first 4 points have just been
dominant.
One block after another and one miss hit after another by Cochran.
Yeah, 4-0 out the get. Lob serve.
There's a better
one.
He's
going to find the back court.
That's a better one there. I got Chance Hoffman got set up that time. He went straight up instead of kind of fading a little bit. Was able to execute the kill.
Yeah, you got to admire Wigton's headgear.
Oh,
it's aerodynamicy at its best.
Aerodynamicy.
That's right. It's it's Mark Sanchez-esque.
I think it just looks good. He gets tricks with that.
Yeah, you do. You know, you got to set yourself apart.
Right.
You know, what are you going to go with, like a different colored knee pad? That doesn't work.
No.
No. That's not how you get prom dates.
Who are the chicks going to remember? That dude in the headband.
The headband, yeah.
He looked cool.
Yes. Oh, look at this. There's about 30 different saves, 30 different ways right there.
Right.
Cochran came up Bupkis, 6-1. Maddox now with the serve. Peter Maddox having a whale of a night so far.
It seemed like
good save by Cochran. Oh, help the net, can't do it.
Maddox seems like he's just born to play volleyball, is he?
Yeah, I got to watch him and his brothers come up through the ranks here. It's just been fun watching them.
Much needed timeout by the Cardinals that time.
Yeah, let's take a quick break. We'll be right back. 7-1 Panthers with the lead over the Cards.
Welcome back to Saegertown. 7-1, second game. Panthers are up. Maddox serving.
And if you're watching the game, Zach Cozart just checked in with a leadoff home run against the Buccos.
Did he really? I don't want to hear that. John Neese continues his pathetic performance.
And we're live.
So you picked him in FanDuel and he leads off with a home run?
It was a risk, yeah. It was because they're expecting rain and I was just like, well, I rode with him on 5 lineups, so we'll see how it pans out. Now back to volleyball action here on Armstrong. Lon Wilson, John Swick. That's going to be out. Maddox sees his streak broken, but a good run, enough to get his name in the paper.
And, of course, you're just playing these games purely for entertainment purposes only.
That's it. That's it. Just for fun.
Big serve.
Wow, that's going to fall down. Johnson handcuffed.
That's maybe what we need a little bit here. Maybe a little offense from the end line. Chance Hoffman. Big winding serve here.
That's right. Cochranton trying to find some room to move. Wow, that's a bullet, but that's out. It looks good on video, but live.
It sounds good.
It's still out, yeah.
But it's still out. And the other team serving. Oh, pooch.
That's right, good little pooch serve. Quick over by Cochranton. Set play coming, Maddox up. Oh, and that's gonna be out. He has Cochranton, they laid their hands back. You know, again, this is a smart young team, and you're gonna see these guys around for a good while.
We haven't seen Maddox miss many, especially
well coached. Maddox out there.
Yeah.
Carries.
Yeah. Looked a little funky there.
Sticky hands.
Cochranton hanging in here.
That's right. Luke Bean, 5'10" junior. Good serve. Wow. Johnson had to throw every forearm into that. Maddox into the back. Bean can't handle that one.
Well, if Maddox gets that two-step approach and he's able to wind up and he's coming straight at the ball, he's tough
if
to stop.
If he's flying from 10 feet away and has that much, you know, room to execute.
Duck.
Yeah, duck. Save your hands. It's going to go to Wigton now. Can't get it over.
Tough set that time. A little too close
to the net.
That's right. He wasn't able to get himself set. And
had to go southpaw on that.
Right.
Luke Smith, good serve. No, that's going to fly out.
Had a lot of bad service.
Yes.
A lot of service errors in these first game and a half here.
Yeah, unforced, and you don't like to see that. And quick punch over Maddox. Good work to dig. Right now, Wigton, he'll have a chance. Oh, he's hurting the net.
It seemed like he didn't get his steps right that time and really didn't elevate.
He had defense waiting for him, though, and he was trying to work around that.
I think maybe that was it. He heard the footsteps, as they say.
That's right. 12 serving six. Saegertown with the lead here in the second. That's going to get over. Stuffed up nicely up front. Hey, Maddox and Triola doing good work. Into the net it goes.
Nicely done that time. Cochranton had the block set up.
Cardinals creeping back into this, okay.
I tell you, Amy's he's a hell of a setter in there, isn't he?
Oh, yeah, he's
a quarterback. He controls the action.
Yeah. Look at that.
Ooh, man.
Look at that. That's making somebody a peanut butter sandwich.
Yep.
And saying, do you want low fat or whole milk?
Step right up.
That's right.
Colton Greenlee it wasn't Colton Greenlee. That was on the other side. Luke Triola and set it down.
He's definitely the cook in the kitchen. That's good.
I think you may have been able to step up and throw that one down. What do you think?
Actually, I lettered 2 years in a row in volleyball. Team captain.
I could see it.
I was a architect. Loved the game. Maddox denied. Oh, that's going to go out.
Carry.
No, they carried, yeah.
Yeah.
And unison clapping by Cochranton. It's impressive. I like that. Shows some esprit de corps. There's that Latin again.
They're their own fans.
There's some Cochranton folk here. They've been relatively quiet, though. They're reserved. I see Joel Ortley in the upper decks up there. I'm surprised. He's usually a season ticket holder sitting in the front.
Yeah, there's some texting going on. It's just not, yeah.
Yeah, I know who texts during games. Set opportunity come for Saegertown behind the head. Now that's going to get wrapped up there. Ross Mackel, not much to work with. There's a 6'1" sophomore too, number 8.
When there's a good
this young man's going to be around a while.
When there's a good dig to Amy in the middle and he's got his options, it's tough to defend because there's a lot of different ways he can go.
Oh, what a save by Maddox. Come on, you got to give it to the kid.
Oh, he slid over the line.
And I still don't see it. No, there's no protest being issued, so apparently it was a clean call. Kenny Custard checking in now, the 6'1" sophomore for Cochranton.
Sophomore.
Maddox set. Amy, cross court, quick punch over. Good smart thinking by Smith. Yeah, two hits.
Yeah, that's the first time we kind of saw a little sloppy play on the offensive side by Saegertown. Really wasn't a tough ball to handle, but was not Not done very well.
Cochran is still hanging around. 10th serve and 16 here in the second game. They're down 1-0. Smith, that's on the line.
That looked like that was in.
Well, we had a conflicting.
I think that was in.
One ref went right, one went left.
It was definitely wasn't deep. It may have been wide. We're standing right here on the end line, and it wasn't deep.
Well, we're going to call outrage.
Outrage!
Quick save there by Cochranton. Now Johnston to Amy, behind the head. Smith tries to put it down. Good save by the Cards. And that's going to be out of bounds. And I tell you, Cochranton did just about everything they could there, 2-5.
Yeah, they did. They're working hard.
Now Maddox back. Boy, he had a good run at the start. He had a 7-point run, 8-point run.
It's a nice jump serve with a great overspin on it.
Yeah, well, look at the length. I mean, he can wind up.
Speaking
into the back. Bean can't handle it.
Speaking of winding up.
That was putting it, the mustard on the burger. Luke Dangle, 6'2". He's a junior, too. So, you know, Saegertown, they've got options returning. Maddox into the backcourt. Wigton, good dig. Boy, good stop up front. Yeah. Better defense. What is going here?
Over the line. Yeah, line. One of Cochran players after that kill.
There's a line infraction. Maddox now. Good job by number 19, Custard, Kenny Custard.
Kenny Custard, he's had a couple nice plays at the net. And he's only a sophomore, as I mentioned earlier, yeah. Basically three guys in the rotation, at least,
you
know, sophomore.
That's what I love, and that's why I like the privilege of doing this here, John. You get to see a lot of these young men, young women on the women's side. They're going to call that in. That looked a little bit long.
Yeah, a little controversy.
Yeah. Coach Custard, though, he's a no contest.
He was okay with that. That was called in. Saegertown wasn't happy.
Oh, dunk by Wigton. He's going to get props.
Little run here by the Cardinals.
Yeah, now they got it within 5. Closest they've been so far here in the second game. They lost the first 25-18. Wow, that was a serve. Good touch. Over the top, yep. They're going to call that back to Saegertown. A little bit too aggressive on the net. I believe that was Ross Mackle, 6'1", sophomore. Wigton now, into the net. He's hurting that part of the net.
Yeah, he's struggling a little bit, especially from that side. He seems to be jumping out instead of up a little bit. I think he needs to get a little more elevation.
Into the center. I don't know if this is going to happen. It's not.
A little sloppy dig that time.
Yeah, and there's Saegertown stretching back out again. And you know what? They'll get that 7-8-point lead, kid, and they'll play you points.
Yeah, especially when you get off to they're able to 5 or 6-0 start out of the gate in this game. Cochran has been playing catch up since that time.
Oh, what a block up front. Smith, Triola right there. Punch over. That was over the line.
Over the line by Amy.
Amy will regret this for the rest of his life. I'm just kidding, just one play. 22-15.
We'll still get a juice box.
He'll get a juice box, he'll get a Capri Sun. They have organic Capri Suns, you know that?
Do they really?
Yeah.
Have you tried that fare?
Yeah, I have actually. It makes you feel good like you're saving panda bears
right
in the environment. Good save in the backcourt by Amy.
It's kind of like the hybrid Tahoe.
That's it, Maddox has to get it over quickly. He does, set coming. Oh, Johnson. Makes a reach for it. Amy, he'll get it over. Into the backcourt it goes. Oh, blocked up front, Triola, and that's going to be out. Saegertown getting aggressive. They're showing off the abs.
I like the play of Colton Greenlee, though. We mentioned him, only a sophomore, 6'3". He was up there
just
banging his away.
Nose in there. So's Chance Hoffman.
Yeah, they didn't win the point, but he's going up against that Saegertown line.
So's Garrett Custard. He's going up there, too, and throwing it down. There's Kenny Custard. We're going to say they're related by chance.
Maybe to the coach as well.
That's right. 23-16. Now Amy sets it. Wow, off the hands.
Wow.
Bean with a valiant effort, but no dice. Game point coming up here. 24-16. One serve away. And I got the knuckleballer back there, Luke Dangle.
Just came off the kill. Now he gets to go back and serve. Oh, nice.
That's one of a slider.
That was a lot of, that was like a, yeah, that was an overhead curveball there. That was a 12-6 break.
25-16, here's a tell of tape in the second game. 2-0, Saegertown with the lead. We'll be back for game number three. Hang in there. Here we go, Maddox, good serve. Cochran, oh, off the buttocks, off the derriere of the referee.
You think the ref could have maybe dug that out?
You think the referee could have, like...
Yeah, just kind of give a little bit of hip check with it.
Give a little bit of hip action there on that, but the can is out of bounds. And I guess according to PIAA rules, you're not allowed to bounce off the hind parts. Let me check the rule book here. Go to the production van. Maddox, good thinking, gonna let that fly.
You gonna stop at the refreshment stand on the way out, Lon, and do any visiting, or just
negative?
Just,
negative.
Head right to the car.
Just soldier right on.
All right.
Just I can see the concession stand from here.
All right.
It's looking pretty scary.
Uh huh.
There we go, Maddox now.
Oh.
Goes with a punch instead of. The kill, Wigton now gets it over Maddox, sets up front. Look at Maddox, just showing how well-rounded he is.
Oh, the block was set up that time. Nicely done by the Cardinals.
But out of bounds it goes.
Boy, that's a shame too. They had a nice block set up.
Did you notice this? Maddox playing the backcourt.
Yes.
When you got an athlete like that that can play your backcourt and set.
It just makes so many more options for the passer.
He covers so much space back there, except there. That one didn't count. Five, three, Cochranton trying to keep this one close. They lose this one, it's over in a best of five.
Be a short night of work for us.
That's right. Block out of bounds, Johnson. I'm sorry, Smith is gonna get the punts.
Yeah, Luke Smith, he's back in his customary role.
Left-hander, southpaw.
Along the right side, the southpaw. Cochran just hasn't been able to figure out that block of that. That they were able to figure out.
Oh, Maddox, good defense in the backcourt. It's gonna go Wigton's way, blocked, down, out of bounds.
It's nice to see Wigton finally get a kill. He's been struggling a little bit. That time he seemed to get up a little bit.
Found the right angle.
Yeah, I think he was a little more aggressive, got a little higher, a little more downward trajectory on the ball.
Now Wigton again. With the serve into the backcourt it goes. Not fooled was Bean. Now Wigton, there's Maddox again. He's gonna take it center court. Oh, look at this, good defense up front by Greenlee. Showing his chops.
Oh.
You know, that was an aggressive blast by Dangle, but too much. Good defense though by Cochranton.
It was a good defense. Maddox is doing it all, he's digging, spiking.
Only down by one right now. Cochranton can even things up here.
And
look
they
at
do.
This.
A little bit of life over there.
That's right, Chance Hoffman says, hey.
On the Cochranton side.
He says, I'm going to prom.
I think the Cardinal fans are putting their cell phones away.
That's right, getting themselves a little unsettled.
Well, I think I see Coach Johnson maybe calling a little timeout.
He might be letting this one ride.
I wonder if
he's going to see how they react. It's only down by one point.
Yeah, but you know, lack of focus, maybe one of those talks, but it's better if the kids can work it out themselves rather than call those timeouts.
Oh, Cochran, and look at Greenlee talking smack.
I think the timeout's coming.
He said, spell my name right. You're right, kid. Johnson calls a timeout. We'll be right back. 8-6, Cochran with the lead here in the third. And back to action. Cochran right now with the lead by two. And Maddox, he says, you know, I'm tired of that lead.
Right. So you think Coach Johnson said, hey, listen, next time out, just get the ball real high. Let's let Maddox fly from the back row.
Yeah.
Get a kill down, get us back on the right side. We'll be good to go.
I think his words, he looked at him and said, really? Really? Yeah. And that was it.
Yeah.
Good serve right to the middle. Hoffman. Wow.
Nicely done.
Hawking gets some momentum here.
Yeah, Hoffman's a little more aggressive there too. He's only a junior, 6'2". Chance. You like that name?
I like that name. My stepson, his middle name is Chance. His brother's middle name is Risk.
Reminds me of an ABBA song.
Yes. Oh, Maddox, ouch, Wigton.
It's gonna hurt somebody.
That's gonna be on Snapchat.
Oh.
That was impolite. Now checking in, Nick Bradley, haven't called his name yet. Bean with the set. Hoffman, good job in the back. Amy, gotta make it happen there. Punch over by Smith. You love that confidence. No, a little too much pinball action. Cochranton now still up by two, 10-8.
A couple nice plays in a row by Hoffman.
Yeah.
Bean settled down a little bit here too in this third game. Passer for
Cochranton. That's gonna be out of bounds. Into the hallway there.
Cochranton stretching the lead out a little bit. Our executive producer, Checkers Corey, said between games, don't count the Cardinals out. They don't go away easily.
He's a gambling man.
He was a little prescient with that prediction.
He is. Oh, Maddox, out right off the noggin.
You know, the block was there, and he just went right up over the block.
Garrett Custard, he's got this shakedown. He's got a little smile on his face.
All right, he got me that time.
Yeah, that's right. He mugged me. Yeah, it was like Maddox looked right at him and said, I got you, kid. Oh, Maddox again. That's going to be out of bounds. Maddox. And I got to hand it to Cochran for even fielding that one.
Yes.
Now it's just a one-point differential. Cochran, you got a little debris on the court there, a little controversy.
Condensation.
That's right, condensation, sweat, whatever you want to call it. Set coming.
Whoa.
Oh, look at that, Hoffman. I'm sorry, no, it's Kenny Custard.
Yeah. He's feeling a little mojo.
He is. Good job by Johnson in the backcourt. Maddox, better defense by Cochran. That was Hoffman in the back. Good save, Johnson. Damey, Maddox gonna have a tough one. Oh my goodness. He had to reach back to Stuttgart, Germany to get an angle on that kill. Did you see that?
And, you know, once again,
I thought it was too far.
Once again, the double block was there. And he has reached back way over his left shoulder.
Yikes.
And just put it right through the block that time.
He's got to have some scouts looking. Oh, Wigton stuffed. Punch over. No, Maddox, he couldn't take the chance. Johnson, oh, what a leg save!
Oh, the foot save.
Oh my goodness, that was reminiscent of Rogie Vachon. They're gonna call that in. That was a goaltender save, Vachon with the pad blocker.
It looked like Matt Murray back there.
He did, I went old school with Rogie Vachon.
So. All right, you go there, I'm gonna go a little new.
I think there
school.
Might be one guy, Dan Craven will be listening. Yeah, I know who that is. Boy, now it goes.
That's that same play we've seen Luke Smith over there on the right side.
Yeah, that one took some hands, though.
Well, order has been restored, at least for the home squad. Back up 13-12, and we'll be right back.
Man, what a fun game to call. We got a good one, kid.
We do.
And Maddox with the serve. Up by one at Saegertown here in the third. Into the back it goes. Wigton denied. Oh, good block. Better dig. That was Smith. Oh, Maddox.
Psych?
That was Psych. Nice job. Oh, the young Custard says, you know what? I see some pine. And Cochranton, they're pushing and shoving, chanting.
By far, Cochranton's best game of the series so far. Passing's better. Spike, the kills are better.
That's right, 13-13. I'd say Hoffman is really
just a little cleaner with the offense.
He's really excelled in his third game for the Cardinals. Oh, what a save. Hey, Amy, he does. He gets two Capri Suns after this, I bet you. Oh, Wigton, good athleticism. Cross court it goes, Wigton again. Amy, where's he going? Over the head. Oh, Smith. Oh, what a save by Beam.
Great save.
That's Al Johnson. Are you kidding? This kid, they're going to call him the Flash.
Boy, what a reactions by Johnson.
He is.
He sensed that. Got one, he sensed and they got the hell out of the way.
I'm telling you, they call him Flash Johnson around this joint.
It wasn't easy since he was lined up right with the incoming ball.
Into the back it goes. That's not going to be saved. Cochran is going to tie it up 14-all. Kenny Custard checking out. Josh Malliard, 5'10" sophomore, checking in.
Maddox is as effective coming from that back row as he is along the net. That time he's playing the back row, couldn't cross the line, didn't matter. Still got the kill.
That's out. Good talk by Saegertown and the bench helping out.
That's a big swing.
It is. That hurts.
Yeah, Cochran had it tied up and just gave 2 points away here.
That's going to be out too. And you know what, Saegertown, that's discipline right there. You'll see younger teams dive for those and go for those, keep them in play. That's court presence. Hoffman.
Wow.
That's going to be out.
Hoffman.
Good effort by Triola.
Yeah, that time Hoffman from the back row. Maybe that's not a bad strategic move by Cochran. Start coming off the net a little bit with the kill.
Yeah, Wigton, he needs to come up aces here on these serves. Amy, quick over. Triola goes southpaw. Hoffman stuffed up front. That one under the net. Cochran now brings it within one.
These young kids at Cochran, they're going to be good. You got Hoffman, yeah. Greenlee, and Custard all coming back next year. A little run here by the Cardinals.
That's right, 17-17 now. I tell you, for Cochran to come in here and take a game, that's something. Amy. Over to Smith, oh, good dig. But that's got to fall out of bounds. Mallard, not to be ashamed of there. Garris now, knuckleball. I love that knuckleball serve. Oh, Maddox, what? Are you kidding me?
Great reactions.
That's out.
That time
the photographer's almost struck with the ball.
Greenlee couldn't get up on top of the ball. He wasn't set.
Can we see that again on replay? Look at the reaction by Maddox.
Yes.
Just that right hand out there.
He's flicked it.
Boy, a little help from the net there. It's coming over to Maddox. Bean, good dig. Oh, Cochran can't get it over. I tell you, Bean and Hoffman made a nice effort.
Yeah, great reaction on him. On the kill by Maddox.
2017. Oh my goodness! Amy and Triola. Triola and Amy. Amy says, don't touch me, I'm hot.
He gets more fired up over those blocks than he does in any sets or any other play that he has during the course of the night. He loves the blocks.
That's going to be in. Nice job. Hoffman on the side, taking the baseline.
Yeah, he kind of came walking from the middle all the way around the outside in one move, got up and made the kill. Well done. Cardinals hanging in.
I'd like to say big hats off to Jeff Corey, our executive producer.
He's looking stylish tonight.
He is. He's got the extra, he's got the tough skins on tonight. Oh, not to be denied, Maddox. He was denied once.
Yeah, Cochran was caught that time. The block was not of their taller men, and that wasn't much of an opposition for Maddox.
Went
right over the block.
Cutter Pritchard into the game, number 13.
Whoa.
And Hoffman said, Cutter Pritchard this.
Yeah, Chance Hoffman gives it right back.
And here we go. Cochran down by three now. In the third game, they need this to stay alive, 22-19. Hoffman, Greenley out, a little bit of a miscue. You know what? That may be the first miscue I've seen all night from Saegertown.
Yeah, that was poorly done, low miscommunication.
22-20 now.
I got it, you take it.
Sorry, Garrett Custard now with the serve. Over to Maddox. Whoa, my goodness, he leaned back.
Way back.
That restores order.
That restores the order in the universe.
To the Panther world.
That's right. Oh, my goodness. Oh. Custard, oh, it goes for 2 points.
Swing and a miss.
It's a 24-20. Amy, one serve away. And then it's juice boxes for everybody.
Organic, please.
That's right. Non-GMO, farm fresh.
Free range.
That's right. Free range juice boxes. Yeah. It's in the apparatus. Oh, it comes down and that'll do it. Saegertown takes it 25-20, 25-16, 25-18. John Swick, we're going to see a lot from this young Cochranton team.
I think so. I think better days are ahead for them. What you did see tonight, though, was the dominance of the Saegertown Panthers. Look forward to seeing them again, probably down the line.
All right, good wrap-up. Lon Wilson, John Swick, Jeff Corey. Have a great night, folks. Final 3-0 Saegertown winners over the Cardinals.